Stream is not live. Start record. Hi everyone and welcome back to match 3 of the second round of the Ryze bracket of the Ryze Up Tournament 2012 put on by the good folks at LLReport.com as we have Any Which Way versus We Give the Best Leashes. Two really good matches, really strong performances by both teams. Any Which Way really handily winning the first match, and We Give the Best Leashes really handily winning the second match. And we got to start, so we're going to get going. Switching right over. Bans and picks are going to be really interesting, as we'll probably see some really focused bans. Both teams. Any Which Way does get first pick and ban again, and they're going to choose Jarvan. Followed by a Warwick ban from We Give the Best Leashes. Both very targeted bans to both teams. We're going to have to see a Morgana ban from Any Which Way. Going very quickly. Ahri ban by We Give the Best Leashes. Another really focused ban, one they chose last time. And we're going to see a Skarner ban, very focused on that jungle. Skarner was chosen by Best Leashes both games.
Yeah, that Skarner last game was so good.
Mm.
Great counter jungling, just really annoying all match. And then we're going to the Shen. So the Shen Warwick is not going to happen on the top lane anymore.
Yep.
We'll have to see if they switch up their picks for this match, though. Because Any Which Way, it was just playing damage control the entire time.
And
they almost kept it to the really late game, but then they didn't scale well, and they didn't get team fights won, so.
All right, looks like we're going to see a Rammus jungle.
Yeah, I told
Ooh,
you.
Ooh, very hyper, nice.
Hyper champions being picked. We could see a Shaco. We could see Kassadin. We could see.
All right, looks like we're going to see the Tristana and Jaina combo again, chosen by Best Leashes. They really like those champions, and Tristana did really well.
Yeah, last game, that was a really good pick. Unfortunately, Rammus is a great counter pick to Tristana.
The defensive curl plus a thorn mail.
Exactly, that could be really dangerous. Oh, Caitlyn, we'll have to see if they go with that.
Yep, they are going to lock in Caitlyn, and they have shown Sona. Not sure if they're going to lock
in. Again, my own personal thought is that Caitlyn is a really great early game, but just not a good mid and late game.
Mm. But if they can control in the early game, they might be able to win this before they get into the late game.
Yeah. Well, it's just that her abilities, like, they're really good in the early game, and they, like, you can reduce the amount of wards that you need because of her traps, and her Q does do a lot of damage in the early game. But in the late game, her traps aren't as effective.
Switching it up from Sona to Cassiopeia at the last second. And we are going to see an Udyr jungle compared to that Rammus jungle.
I think that's a pretty good counter pick. Udyr has a much faster jungle, and he has a much more aggressive jungle, so he can counter jungle Rammus a lot.
Yeah, we are going to see that Olaf chosen once again.
Yeah, we'll have to see if they decide to go with a different top lane. They're going to go with Yorick, maybe. He's going to be really strong in the early and mid game, but unfortunately he scales terribly in the late game.
We are going to see that Sona support, though.
Yeah, it was just picked on a different champion. We could see a switch, though. They may have decided that they wanted to pick Cassiopeia up quickly because we have a Flash and Ignite on that Sona right now. So
yeah, they might be discussing who to pick, just showing Yorick.
Yeah, that's very possible because he'll do good in the early game, and his harass will probably beat Olaf's range. But the late game is going to be a problem because Kate does not scale well.
And
Yorick doesn't scale.
Final
well.
Seconds, 2-1, and it is going to be locked in as Yorick.
Okay, so I have to see how well he does. If he gets an early advantage, he'll be okay, but ooh, and Nivea, that's going to be a really strong middle.
Absolutely. Really good to set up ganks, too, with that Udyr stun and then that wall preventing her from running back.
Yeah, and she has a stun, too, so.
Yep, and a slow.
Yep.
Really good choice. I don't know. Best Leash is very strong. Very strong team.
Yeah, and their team scales really well in the late game. Like, Cass does scale well. Sona has really great initiate, and Rammus scales insanely well.
Yeah.
So I have to see. Like, that Rammus is going to be, you know, the deciding factor on how well they do. If they win the early and mid game, then they'll be fine. If they don't, and the Rammus has to wait until he can get a good enough farm up to be super tanky in the late game, then it's just going to be like last time where they just have to wait out and see if they can make it to the point where gold doesn't matter anymore.
But even then, York and Caitlyn don't really scale, so if they get to that point...
Yeah.
Will be an interesting match. We are in the final countdown. Looks like we are going to see a teleport from Demonio Gomez. Lots of ignites. Two heals. Yeah, that's all locked
in. Yeah, like I said, that Tristana Jana, they didn't have teleports, or flashes, I'm sorry. Mm. And I was like, oh, that's a mistake. They're just going to be ganked all day long. But then they never died.
Yeah.
So they did really well. And they pushed their lane the entire match, and they never died.
Yeah.
And Tristana always got away. And Jana, perfect ultimates, perfect her whirlwinds and stuff. So they did really well. They're really comfortable with that combination.
Yeah, absolutely.
That double heal, I think, went a really long way to making sure they didn't die.
Yes, we'll have to see that taunt, though, and that defensive curl.
Yeah, that's really... Because he can taunt Tristana, and she's going to blow herself up. He can taunt Olaf, and he's going to blow himself up. Udyr will have to see which way he goes. He can go either Phoenix or Tiger. If he goes Tiger stance, then yeah, you don't want to fight Rammus. If he goes Phoenix stance, it won't be as bad. I think he'll probably go Phoenix, since they have an AD top and an AD bottom. For him to go AD 2 would be a little much.
Yeah.
He could go kind of balance. Like, there are also the people that go, like, just a little bit into Bear Stun, and then not much into Turtle, and then go Phoenix and Tiger. But that's a really weird build. Like, you have to build Trinity Force, and then you'd have to build, like, a Hextech Gunblade and stuff. So,
yeah.
It's a strange build, but I have seen it, so.
All right. As far as Summoner spells, both teams have Exhaust. No one has a CV again. That double heal with the Ignite. No ghosts this time.
Yeah, no ghosts.
But we'll have to see how Stop Taking My Name does with Skarner. Or not Skarner, Udyr, because he was so effective with Skarner.
Yeah, like, it was weird, because the first match, he was bad. Like, well, it wasn't that he was bad, but he was always out of position. And every time he went for a gank, Shen's like, no. And then every time that he went for a bottom gank, he got out of position, and then Alistair punished him for it.
Yeah.
But this match, or then the next match, he did so great.
Yeah.
So you wonder if it was really just that all those top lane gank fails were really the thing that was putting him so far behind. Because even, like, he didn't even counter jungle that much in the first game.
Yeah.
But then in the second game, he was always in Udyr, or in, not Udyr, Warwick's jungle.
Yeah.
Or not even Warwick, cool. Second game, Trundle, thank you. Yeah, and Trundle, he scaled terribly in that last game. It didn't matter. He just died. His pillars were, like, all that he was offering. And even then, he just wasn't doing a lot of damage. Like, I've seen some Trundles that attack and get, like, a Trinity Force and just never die. And just take out teams one at a time, just running up the lane, killing each of them. And everyone's like, oh, and they keep blowing him up. And then he just keeps healing himself. And that just wasn't happening. He was just like, pillar, run in, oh, I'm almost dead, run out, and then he dies.
He had some good pillars, he's just so far behind in that.
Yeah,
Alistair got so far behind,
They were good
too.
Defensive pillars, though. Like, he didn't have a great initiate pillar.
Well, with that, Olaf just being like, you can't slow me down.
Oh, we got a Ninja Rama skin, though.
Awesome. I don't know, I'm going to have to give it to Any Which Way Now. They have a Ninja Rama skin.
Yeah, right. They all have skins except for Yorick.
Yeah. We do have a nice Sona skin, the usual Caitlyn skin, Cassiopeia, the opposite skin to what Best Leashes has. But we do have an Anivia skin, an Udyr skin, and a Jaina skin.
That's a really sick Anivia skin, too.
Yeah.
I like all the Hextech skins and stuff.
Yeah, they're so cool. I like the Hextech feel for everyone.
Yeah. I'm trying to think about who the best one is. I'd have to say Morgana probably has the best, like, metallic. That one just looks so awesome, even in-game and out-of-game. Because there's a lot of skins that look great artwork-wise, But then you actually get into the game, and their modeling just isn't that good.
Yeah.
Like, Grim Reaper Karthus looks great. You know, it's good artwork. But then you get into the game, and it's all, like, his robe is all, like, really tight against his body, and it just looks weird, and it just doesn't look the same.
Yeah, absolutely. I do hate how sometimes the pictures are way cooler than the actual champions look.
Or just, like, the second Ryze skin where, like, they turn him, like, he's, like, really pale white, and he has all these different linings and some different clothes and stuff, and he doesn't have any, like, the tattoos. But it looks awesome artwork-wise, but in-game it literally just, like, looks like a white Ryze.
Yeah.
It's like Ryze is now albino. That's the only difference.
Yeah, and just, like, if you're going to spend real money on skins, you want, like, significant differences.
Right. That's why I like the Wukong skin, where he's mulling
it.
Oh,
yeah, that's so awesome.
Looks so good.
Rammus has just, all his skins are awesome.
Yeah, Warwick skins are all pretty good, too.
Absolutely. All right, looks like everyone is summoning. Hopefully we'll be going.
Yeah, we couldn't pick on anyone for summoning time.
Yeah.
I actually don't even know when they finished because we were talking about skins so much, but now we're still waiting, so hopefully we don't have to, like, a disconnect.
Hopefully there's not a disconnect. There we go, we're in. And everyone, I think, is moving. Yeah. Nivea is still waiting. Oh, that is really cool looking. All right. Oh, Cassia. There we go. Cassiopeia is moving in. Let's see if we see any invades this time.
Yeah, they played it really safe both games for jungle-wise, but...
Welcome to Summoner's Rift.
Oh, we got the good luck have funs. Looks like Rammus is coming in. Probably setting up defensive.
Like, are you really the mother?
We got the yes. Alright. I think we're going to see the standard defensive play. We got that ward there. You got a creepy for my Snapple, you.
Minions have
don't call my mom creepy.
We can say it, but it's just like, you know, gaming is getting older now.
Absolutely.
You know, like all the people that were playing Nintendos and stuff are now in their 40s and 50s, so it's not that unusual to see older gamers, especially with games that make gaming much more available to older players, like World Warcraft, stuff like that, you know. You have people that are 12, and you have people that are, like, 65, and they're all playing the same game.
Mm.
You know, so games like while competitive gaming is generally a smaller or a younger crowd, you can still have some of the people that are a bit older. And I think that out of all the competitive games out there, League of Legends is the one that requires the most mental skill and probably not as much of the physical reflexes required in games like first-person shooters or real-time strategy games. So.
And what's interesting is there's a lot of studies out there that are showing like that even for like older generations, especially for older generations, by letting them play video games and doing stuff like that, it increases hand-eye coordination and really helps out problem-solving into later life.
Yeah, because they have something that's letting them maintain their ability to multitask.
Mm-hmm.
And... you know, at work, depending on what kind of career field they're in, they may not get that opportunity.
Yeah, absolutely. And it makes learning and, like, trying out new abilities and, like, using the same abilities over and over again fun. Like, honestly, LOL is the same game over and over and over again with a lot of different variables, but, you know, same objectives, but it's still fun.
Right.
So you get better at doing a... ooh, nice zoning by that Caitlyn.
Yeah, she has such a great range on her auto attack.
Yeah, that that's might be a really good answer to Tristana, to be honest with you.
That's why her early game is so dangerous, but I'm saying that later on, Tristana scales better. So, if Tristana just doesn't overcommit in the early and mid game, she'll be fine. As long as she just focuses on last hitting and only jumps in when a great gank is going
to
happen.
Alright, looks like we have Odir trying to invade early on. Maybe catch that Rammus out of position. But he's going to come up, try to get the... taking turret shots, though. Flash by Cassiopeia. It's going to be safe. Still low on health.
I honestly think what they should have done was Anivia should have gone in and gone for the dive because of her passive.
Oh,
and then
yeah.
Have Udyr back out and then only go back into a stun if they really needed to. And they could have guaranteed a kill because she was low.
Alright, looks like they're setting up here. Ooh, great setup by Rammus. Able to taunt. Nice flash. But Rammus flashes in too. Going to try
Janna
and duke it out.
Save. Nice.
Very nice. Good play on both teams. Nice flash by Udyr. Nice counter flash by Rammus. Trying to catch Udyr off, preventing him from being able to gank. And then Rammus goes back to double golems and Udyr's forced to go back.
Tim, Yorick is starting to run into the problem where he has great harass on Olaf, but he's running out of mana. And then he has to go back. And that's the biggest problem. Like, see, he's doing a lot of damage. And he is maintaining equal CS, so he's doing okay on that front. But if he spams a little too much, then he's going to just keep running out of mana and having to keep back. And that gives Olaf free farm time, which is really dangerous, especially with all the buffs from him.
Yeah.
I think it's the one problem. Like, the reason why Yorick scales so bad is because his early game is all based around having, like, a blue buff. So a lot of people play Yorick top, but I really think he needs to be a middle player. I think he would do much better there, because then he could be fed blues. Because you don't feed, like, well, in the current meta, like, I guess you could switch the meta up and feed your blues on top, and have, like, a Ken in middle or something like that.
A nice ward by Any Which Way really shuts down any counter jungling by Udyr. They're really doing a good job preventing him from getting in their jungle and taking anything. We do have the teleport in by Yorick.
Yeah, I guess that's a good choice with the teleport, because then if he goes back, he's not as punished as much from having mana problems.
Let's see, how's CS looking? We have 36 to 36, so dead even on bottom. Let's see, Olaf has 34 and Yorick has 20, so Olaf is ahead. Rammus is 33 to, where is he? Udyr's 27. So Rammus is a little bit ahead, and Nivea has 37, and Cassiopeia has 34, so pretty
even. I'm surprised
even
that Rammus is ahead. I don't know if he sat in a lane and, like, defended for someone, but Udyr, should be ahead. He has a much faster jungle player. Okay, he's starting to even out and catch up. So eventually Udyr should overtake that, unless Udyr tries to go for a lot of ganks that aren't effective.
Yeah, we still have very even gold. Nice harass by Sona, doing a lot of damage to that Janna with that one ability. Ooh. Looks like Kitten's coming in. Tristana jumping in. Looks like they might be able to get first blood. Udyr's coming in to wrap around.
So close.
Oh, nice
so
heals. Oh, is she going to get it? She does pick up first blood. But Caitlyn's going to be able to take out Udyr and maybe
she
Tristana.
Turn this into a double kill.
She very well could, but I don't think she's moving fast enough. Oh, she does have the ult. Not blocked by Janna, but it wasn't enough to take down Tristana. Very impressive.
Yeah, Janna did at least throw up a shield, so that was nice.
So it looks like we have a 1-for-1. First blood going to best Leashes. But as far as gold is concerned, we're pretty much dead even. Although it looks like Any Which Way does have a little bit of an advantage. 200, not by much. Nothing to write home about. Rammus coming in to do some counter jungling of his own.
and then backing out immediately.
Yeah.
Anivia, as soon as you saw Anivia start to move.
Yep. Probably a wise decision. Caitlyn really starting to do some damage here. Getting really ahead of Tristana. Two levels now. Let's see if that early game advantage really comes into play here. We do have a battle going on. Oh, nice ult by Cassiopeia. Is able to take down Udyr and hardly take any damage herself. Excellent job. Sorry you guys caught the very end of that, but we were able to see it. She did get that ult directly on him. He was frozen and did enough damage. This is really going to put Rammus ahead now. And gives any which way a slight gold advantage.
That's two ganks. That Udyr died from, so.
Yeah.
We'll have to see how well his damage control is. Unfortunately, Rammus has just been jungling. And he's only tried to gank like once, maybe twice. But since he has Powerball, he just gets back to his jungle faster.
Yeah.
So, if Udyr doesn't.
Oh, it looks like we have a lot of damage to Olaf. But it's not.
Yeah, he's out of mana. So.
Yeah. Looks like he's just going to try and last it off his turret. Ooh, Tristana able to pick up the kill off of Caitlyn. Evening things out at 2-2. Solana's gonna force to go back. It looks like we might have a successful. Nice juke by.
Oh no, that was actually a bad juke.
Yeah, chucking it up.
But
Rammus is coming in. She flashes up. Tristana gets the kill, but they might be able to pick up the kill off of Tristana. She's too fast,
yeah,
though.
With the stun, and then, yeah, comes back.
But Cassiopeia's coming down. Gonna start...
miss the original poison though,
yeah.
So her Twin Fang is on cooldown now.
Gonna push Jenna back though, with Tristana. They are up by a kill though, and 200 gold. So it does look like it's gonna be a very even match between Any Which Way and Best Leashes. Best Leashes with a tiny advantage right now. We'll see if they can capitalize on that. Nice kill by Tristana, who's already 3-0 now. And she's going to start snowballing.
Right,
soon.
I was going to say, last match she was so far ahead. And this
yeah, they really need to shut her down now. She's Caitlyn still maintains that level lead.
Yeah, her CS is a lot better, so. She doesn't have to hit off the tower like Tristana has, but Tristana has 3 kills, so she already has her boots finished. She already got a Vamp Scepter, and she's going double Doran's, and she has a few health potions. So it is kind of evening out, because Caitlyn has the same thing, but she's getting killing sprees off of her kills now. So if Tristana keeps up those killing sprees, she'll be getting a lot more gold as she keeps killing them.
Oh, and she's doing lots of damage to Sona, who looks like she misclick, but Rammus is coming, and Tristana does pick off the kill off Sona, so good ult by Jaina's pushing Rammus back, so I think she tried to juke or something, but she just basically fed Tristana another free kill. Not looking good for bottom. Now they are 2 kills ahead, and coming up on a 1,000 gold lead for Best Leashes. Well, it looks like Udyr's going to try and grab for blue, but Cassiopeia is right there. And Udyr might try to set up the steal. Rammus is coming in. Nice slow, pushing him back. Not enough to kill him though.
Yeah, just wanting to secure that blue. But she's gonna give the cast, which will make her middle lane farm even better.
Yep, but it looks like Udyr's coming in to give Anivia their blue as well to try and answer that.
Yeah, so Anivia's ultimate has so much farm potential, so if she keeps getting fed blues, I think she could even beat Cass on farm status, as long as she maintains sitting in there. If Cass wanders too much, then it'll help her. But Cass wandering is also really dangerous, because then she could just, you know, ult someone out of a bush and get a triple kill.
Well, we do have several pings towards Dragon. Yeah, you're right. Despite the very strong kill lead, Caitlyn is really answering with just getting more CS.
But that Tristana has picked up a BF sword.
Ooh.
So her damage is even more insane. And we've already seen her take out Sona, no problem. I think three of those kills are Sona. But one is Caitlyn, so.
Yeah. Yep. Sona's getting caught out of position, needs to play it a little safer. But Rammus is coming down. There are no wards down in this area. They do have a ping that... Oh, they do have a ward down there, so they do know Rammus is down there. Ooh, looks like Janet's caught in a trap. Alright, Rammus picking up double golems. Yorick, a little bit ahead in level.
But he's at 72 CS. And
Olaf's at 84. So. Alright, they do know that Rammus keeps coming in, but Udyr's here. They're going to see him come down, though. Walk right down in here. And Caitlyn comes in, sets up a trap. Doing more damage to Tristana. And Rammus is back. Just kind of sitting on nothing, though. Udyr getting ahead.
Yeah, Udyr is now at 67, so he's playing some good recovery by sitting in this jungle and just getting up some good farm.
Absolutely. And Rammus just missing those ganks. Nice tri-bush ward for best leashes. Looks like Tristana's really trying to focus and get another kill off of Sona. And they do have a 900 gold lead for best leashes. We have several pings down here. Ooh, Tristana really focusing on that tower. Trying to take it down. Oh, we do have the ult. Rammus coming in. She does jump, but she is exhausted. Nice ult from Jaina prevents them from getting the gank. They're really doing
She jumps right over that trap from Caitlyn.
Yeah, wow. Like, they're doing a really good job at preventing her from dying, and that's what they need to do. It's ridiculous.
Yeah,
but
that Jaina is so good. Like, so many people are like, oh, Jaina's terrible because she doesn't have any sustain, but it's like, well, she does have some sustain from her ultimate, but she has so much control, and she can all. Like, she can get to the point where it's so hard to kill someone that she's sitting on and protecting.
Absolutely. That Olaf taking a lot of damage, though.
So we may have a gank from that Udyr, though. Or no, he's just babysitting.
Yep.
The lane, so Olaf can go back. Item-wise, though, that Yorick has picked up a Tears, built some damage, and picked up a Mana Crystal.
And looks like the bottom turret's gonna go down. Tristana doing so much damage.
It's just ignoring them.
Yep. First tower goes down. Four best leashes. That's one tower. Now they are solidly, solidly 1,000 ahead. Starting to creep up on two.
So now that causes a couple problems. Like, Caitlyn now has an easier lane farm-wise, but that also means that Tristana can start roaming, and that's really dangerous. Because that Tristana's already pretty fed.
Yeah. Absolutely. She has four kills now. So she's picking up her pick. Another ward by Udyr. Looks like we might be seeing a setup for Dragon as Cassiopeia and Rammus start to head down here. But they do have that warded all over the place. So
yeah, great wards from both teams.
Any which way. Oh, it looks like they might be trying to steal blue. But Anivia's right there. Coming in, getting this round with Tristana right there.
Again, Sona's out of position.
No one there to back her up. Doesn't have a tower, but Tristana wisely ignores it, backs off, jumps away. And will they engage Dragon? No, they will not. And looks like they're going to go for blue. And doesn't look like any which way is going to have any way to answer that. So they're not going to contest it. Looks like Cassiopeia is going to grab her blue. Ramus. But on top, it does look like York is maintaining a slight lead, especially in levels.
Yeah, he picked up a mana moon, so he's having less and less mana problems. So his mid game, he's getting pretty strong. Olaf himself has picked up like a Wriggles and then some magic resist. He's probably going to build a Merc Treads and then a little bit of Hell.
All right, we do have the dragon coming in, but any which way is trying to engage. They do reset dragon. They might have saw them come in, so they do know that they're there. And Nivea trying to engage, but kind of caught out of position. Gonna have to go a long way around. Yorick still pushing top. We do have a few pings in middle here. Yep, now they're gonna see that. Ooh, nice trap from Caitlyn. Alright, Tristana pushing the lane. Tristana has blue.
Yeah, I think she got it from the kill.
Yeah.
No, she hasn't killed him in a while.
Nope. Oh, we do have the flash coming in. Oh, is Jaina gonna go down? Yes, she does. A nice ignite. I didn't think she was gonna go down. I thought that was gonna burn out.
End.
But nice ignite from Cassiopeia picking up that kill. She's 2-0 as well, so if she gets a couple more kills, she's gonna catch up to Tristana.
I love how everyone just runs away from Tristana.
Right?
She's like all by herself, she can totally get ganked. She's out of position. And they're all just like, no. Leave her alone.
Alright, they do have a nicely placed ward on Dragon. Tristana just roaming all over the place. But Caitlyn's there to farm on bottom. Looks like Sona, Ramus, and Cassiopeia are trying to position themselves for another kill to catch up. They are catching up in gold, though.
Jaina just did pick up that Oracle, too, so we're going to see some good counter warding, and they can start clearing the wards around Dragon so they can start pulling that.
But if they gank her again, that's 400 gold wasted. Oh, we do have a ping.
She normally doesn't get out of position, though. Like, Sona gets out of position a lot.
Yeah.
But this Jaina, she didn't even really get out of position. She got flash ulti. So she figured she was safe. You know, she was probably a little overextended. But other than that, she was fine. Oh, she missed it, though.
Yeah, nice ward, though. Very nice ward.
Oh, is she checking again? Okay, there we go.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah, yes. Yeah, she does check it. She does see it. But here comes Ramus and Cassiopeia with Caitlyn. Udyr's coming in.
Does have the ward. Stepped out too far.
Gonna back off just in time. Here comes Ramus. Udyr all by himself. But now supported by Tristana and Jaina. Ramus just waiting in there. Ooh, nice trap. Maybe we could pick on him a little bit. Good flash. And a teleport from Yorick. Kind of sneaking in there. Looks like they're going to do a 5-man dragon. And really catch up in gold now. They're only 8k behind. Focusing on dragon. Here comes the team fight. Lots of damage on Sona. Sona's going to have to get out of there. Yes, the dragon did go to Any Which Way, who are now ahead in gold. Nope, they are now tied in gold, so they did catch up and are slightly, ever so slightly ahead.
Yeah, CS-wise, that Ramus is at 83, yeah. So he's still neck and neck with Udyr, which I just don't understand.
That's weird. Olaf doing a lot of damage to that tower, though.
Yeah, he's pretty low, and York just came up. Mm. I think he's at full health, almost full man, so.
Yeah, looks like Caitlyn starting to get ahead in level with Tristana.
Yeah, her farm's at 188 compared to 166,
ooh.
So. She's about 22 ahead.
Caitlyn does have a kill. It's not 4 kills, but...
But the big difference is Tristana has an Infinity Edge.
Yeah!
Caitlyn has her BF Sword, but that's a long way from Infinity Edge. She could also go Bloodthirster, which means she would need about 900 gold to finish that one off. But a Caitlyn Bloodthirster just won't win against a Tristana with an Infinity Edge and a Vamp Scepter, because she has a steroid to increase her attack speed, so...
Mm.
And Caitlyn doesn't. Okay, we just had the Infinity Edge finished on Caitlyn.
Oh, we do have that pinged. So it looks like Jaina's going to come up and counter ward that. Or just head down anyway. So there's going to be a new deer coming down. Ah, looks like we're setting up for a blue. Rammus coming in, wolves, Cassiopeia coming in. So both teams are going to take their blue. Although...
yeah, we'll have to see. Like, they gave it to Tristana last time, or that may have been an accident. She may have just hit it or something.
It probably was an accident.
Either way, Anivia is still at 205 CS compared to 201 of Cass. So even though she's missing one full cycle of blue, she still maintains CS. So. Mm.
Wow, that Yorick really pushing back.
He's building really tanky, so it's like Olaf can't do anything against him, but he's also like Yorick can't just like outright kill him. So
yeah,
the lane is relatively even. We'll just have to see if that becomes a bigger issue later on when we get into more team fights. Because if Olaf starts doing more damage and Yorick just keeps dying to like Tristana, then that could be a problem.
Yeah. Looks like Yorick's coming. Oh no, he's just boarding around. Coming back in to engage. Right, we do have several pings. Ooh, missed by Anivia. Tristana alone. So gankable right now.
Right? It's like, gank me, and no one's there. They're not even going through.
Yeah.
They're just like, no, ignore the Tristana. Don't fear her anymore. But then she's catching up in CS, you know?
Yeah.
She's like, she was at like a 40 gap, and now she's at 192 compared to 210. So.
Yeah, but Caitlyn is going to be picking up a lot of CS here. They really need to take down that Janna too with that Oracle. Being very effective.
Yeah, clearing all the wards, it's really nice. They got mid, probably the most standard lane. They get their blues, they CS.
Yeah.
They try to help their rivers. I think Cass has a slightly better time though, because she is 2-0 compared to Anivia, who's full zeros. But Anivia's built her ROA, he's gone with tiers, so she's going to have less and less mana problems. While Cass has gone a little more spell bank damage side, so has a little less health and a little less sustainability mana wise.
We do have a counter ward by Sona, though. So she's going to start counter warding for any which way, too, which is going to be really good. And it looks like the second tower is going to go down in favor of Best Leashes, taking on their second tower. Any which way has no towers taken down, and not a lot of damage to them. There's a lot of roaming going on here. Well, Rammus comes in, almost...
I think he flashed that ultimate.
I'm not really sure what happened.
It didn't hit.
Yeah.
Or it was... it almost looked like it was delayed, because it's like she went to go hit Rammus, but it's her teammate.
Yeah.
So...
alright, looks like Tristana's coming in with Jaina. Three-person gank. They're probably going to try to take out this final outer turret. No one's really there to back her up. Rammus is coming in, but he's going back.
Yeah, deciding against that when they see that there's four people in the middle.
Yeah. Cassiopeia are holding her own, though. At least for now. Looks like Caitlyn's coming in. How about... ooh, wow, lots of criticals.
Hey, Caitlyn is sitting at 242 CS, and she has picked up a Zeal. Tristan has also picked up a Zeal, though, so... it's like, it's not even, but it is even. You know, Tristan is constantly down in CS, but those four kills that she got in the beginning of the game are just carrying all of that CS that Caitlyn is getting ahead of her.
Alright, we've got a lot of indecision from both teams, kind of moving all around the map, trying to get anywhere they can. Looks like Anivia and Udyr are going to try and invade and grab this blue, but we do have a ping on Jaina. Udyr, missing blue, getting out of there. Ooh, this might be really good for any which way. Come in, nice, all doing lots of damage. Able to take down Tristana, getting the shutdown, which is the extra gold. And nice ult, but isn't enough to kill Udyr. Not Udyr, Olaf. They kind of look the same to me for some reason. I don't know why. And looks like we're setting up Dragon, which they feel very comfortable doing now that Tristana is gone. They take Dragon. They're now equal in kills, ahead in gold, had both Dragons, but they are behind in towers. So let's see if they can turn around their tower gap, too, and really capitalize on a nice little gank on Tristana.
Yeah, if they shut down Tristana, then that's going to be the strongest person that they want to get rid of, because she has all of their kills.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, Akinivia is pretty dangerous, so she gets a good ulti off, but she went with more health and sustainability rather than pure damage, so she's not going to be doing as much damage as Cassiopeia is going to be doing.
Mm.
And Olaf is also built relatively tanky to try to maintain, living in that lane against Yorick. And Yorick, one of Manamune, which is like, it's good sustainability, but it also gives him damage. So.
Yeah. So I think really good choices by any which way here. Just trying to forcing them to go tanky so that they can go more damage and really build up to that point where they can start steamrolling. And it looks like they're going to probably grab their first tower. Caitlyn really focusing on that. No one there to answer it. And they grab their first tower now. Really capitalizing on a 1,000 gold lead and creeping up to 2k now. Yeah, if they show a little bit more, they might get 2k. They are dead even in kills, one behind in towers, but they had two dragons. Cassiopeia chasing off Tristana. Caitlyn really starting to
just going
here.
Farm crazy.
Ooh.
Almost at 270.
Look at this, we do have a Rammus coming in. He can't be disabled, though, so you can't knock him up. Nice ult. That Olaf just...
Olaf ult wins again.
Just kind of got to ignore him and take out anyone else you can.
That's the worst part, is you're like, okay, you burned his ult, yay, but then his ult has such a short cooldown that by the time you go to gank him again, he has it again.
Ooh, nice trap. Set off by Anivia.
Yeah, just eat it so that way they didn't have to worry about it later.
Mm. Absolutely. And it looks like top lane's pretty pushed too. So we might have a team fight going on here. Oh, we do have Sona targeted. No, she was able to get back just in time. That movement speed buff that she has is really good. Ooh, nice. Is he going to get the taunt? He gets the taunt. Flashes in, and they just eat her alive. Jaina goes down 5-4 in favor of any which way. They are now solidly 2,000 gold ahead. Ahead in kills, one behind in turrets. Best leashes. Starting to fall behind now.
However, Nivea's zone is so strong. Her ultimate hits almost the entire lane.
Yeah, that's such a good... Yeah, that's... Is a really good ult. And she can just turn it on and turn off whenever she wants. Ooh, nice hit. They might be able to catch her off guard.
Wall
completely shuts her down, but she finds a way out of there. But Tristana jumps in, picks up the kill, evening things out at 5-5.
And evening up gold almost, too.
Yep. Well, they're still about 2k ahead. Yorick running away. Looks like they might try to do Baron.
Whoa, it's warded. That could be so bad.
And that's exactly what they're
going to
do.
Anivia's so low. She hasn't hurt.
Here they come. They come in ult from Sona.
Beautiful Sona ult.
Tristana jumps out of there, but they focus down Anivia. Anivia goes down. Next, they're going to focus on Sona. Sona goes down, but Caitlyn takes out Udyr. They focus down Tristana. Yorick is able to take down Tristana, and then Caitlyn takes out Olaf. Wow, a 2-for-4 trade in favor of any which way. And now they're going to focus on Baron. Although Rammus is so low. You better get out of there. He might die. Jaina trying to do something. Not really sure what she can do. She's the only one alive. So if she steals it, she's the only one with Baron buff. So, yeah, that's cool and all that she stole it, but... Nope, not enough to steal it. They pick up Baron buff now, too. So it's a 4-2 trade and Baron buff. They are now solidly 5k ahead in gold. I can't believe Rammus survived that. And I'm pretty sure all members got it. Nope. Sona was unable to pick up that buff. She had just spawned a little bit too late. Great team fight by any which way. Really turning it around in their favor in this match.
Yeah, that ward
on Baron was what gave them that Baron. They're like, oh, look, they're Baroning. Really?
Yeah,
they're Baroning?
poor time to Baron for best leashes. Still being really good. This is a very even match.
Yeah, it was just Janna didn't pick up another Oracle when she died, when she got out of position.
Mm.
Which, if they picked up an Oracle, they would have seen the ward and they wouldn't even have gone for it.
Yeah.
You know, I think that was like, I don't know if they just didn't know where they were or if they were being a little we're clearly in the lead or something.
Yeah.
You know, but that was such an awkward Baron time. There was really no reason for it, and there was no prep to see if they were warding against it.
Yeah. Absolutely. And now they have Baron buff. Let's see what they do with that Baron buff. They are still playing fairly defensively, so I'm not really sure what they want to do. If they take another tower, they will be solidly ahead.
Right, they're in an advantage, but yeah, they're not in such an advantage that they're going to just win the game from it.
Yeah.
Even if they play defensive throughout the entirety of the match, they still need to push this advantage really hard.
Yeah. Oh, they're doing a lot of damage focusing on Olaf. He flashes out, but it isn't enough, and Caitlyn picks up the kill.
The Olaf ultimate doesn't work when poison's on you.
Right? And when you have, you know, most of the team focusing on you.
Yeah.
So we do have some pings inside, but they did already grab blue. Looks like York's coming and just eating that Anivia all.
Kate's in the back, though.
Ooh, yeah, she gets rid of that tower. Now it is 2-2.
Great.
But they did take a middle to it. Yeah. So, honestly, that wall kind of worked against them that time. They flashed over it, ignored it, and now they're focusing on damage to Udyr. Nice protective wall from Janna.
Rammus roll fails. So
yeah, that's frustrating sometimes. Wow. Caitlyn doing lots of damage.
Such distance.
Just eating Anivia up. And it looks like they're really going to push for this turn, too. That'd be a great lead for them if they take it.
Yeah.
And that's exactly what they're going to do. They take that, they're going to flash in all. Nice, they're going to focus down Tristana. Tristana goes down, and they're going to take the inhibitor. They might win from this. They took down Tristana. She's on a 50-second delay. They don't have Anivia anymore. They're just going to push for the lead.
See, this is perfect. Like I said, you know, they have a great middle.
Oh, they take down Udyr?
That Caitlyn did so much damage.
Oh, and they're going to take down that Olaf, too. It goes to any which way. Just one poor Baron, and oh my god, they take it for the win. Absolutely incredible match. Very good game.
Yes, they ended it exactly when they needed it to. They had great. You know, Demonio Gomez was still very effective because it wasn't in the super late game.
Victory.
And Caitlyn was extremely effective again because it was in the mid game where they shine. So,
yeah, absolutely. Really effective play. Really capitalized on just one mistake. And sometimes in League of Legends, that's all you need to do. You make one poor move, and if the team knows how to capitalize on it, they just do. And it showed.
Yeah, that was a great play by both teams. They both did really good, you know, but they just shut down that Tristana, and that's really what they needed. And good picks, good play style, great. That Baron, I'd say that was the only one where I'm like,
yeah,
really, you're just going to Baron with no Oracle?
Yeah.
That was a bad decision, and that lost them the game.
But,
so,
again, we want to congratulate, we give the best leashes for getting it. This far into the Ryze Up Tournament, they are going to win a prize. I believe it's the $10 gift certificate.
Yeah, they're really far, so.
Yeah, they might actually get another prize, depending on.
Yeah, with all the losers break
yeah.
and stuff. They don't show that on the site, though, so it's all stuff that you get contacted about.
Yeah, so definitely, guys, great game, great set of matches. Congratulations on getting it this far. We give the best leashes. You guys did really well. You should be proud of yourselves. And we hope to see you again. And we do hope to cast for you again. So definitely don't give up. Keep trying. This was really good and really well played. And for any which way, congratulations. You are moving on to the semifinals of the Ryze Up Bracket and the Ryze Up Tournament 2012. Congratulations.
Which also means we get to show your theme song.
Yep.
Now we're gonna give you the name of the song before we stop the YouTube, so that way YouTubers can check it out on their own time if they decide they want to see the theme song of Any Which Way. It's quite a hilarious video and it's a pretty funny song. So if you want to do that, check out Scissors Sisters, and the theme song name is Any Which Way. So you can go ahead and research that on YouTube and check it out. We're going to stop the stream now, though, because we don't have rights to show it on YouTube. We don't want to get our video cut off, and then we will show it for the rest of the streamers. Thanks, guys.
Thanks for watching. Don't forget to go to lolreport.com. Show them your love. They're the ones that put on this tournament. And continue to follow us, like us, subscribe us. All that stuff. We want to really build up a community around here. We do want to do a lot more shoutcasting. We'd like to really do this for you. So check us out at youtube.com/d3powerunderwhelming and own3d.tv/power_underwhelming. We will have the numbers up for you, so then you can go to the live chat when we are live and discuss with anyone else that's viewing. So thank you for watching.
One last thing, though. We also have a channel in League of Legends now that's just Power Underwhelming with a space in between the words. We have myself and Magnan also on that channel. You can set it up to where you auto-join right as you launch your League of Legends. Mm-hmm. So make sure to join up with that too. We want to try to get everyone in there so we can talk to people. We can get like either scrim set up or, you know, just play matches with people and have some fun, you know, build a good community. So make sure to do that too.
Absolutely. So again, have a good night, guys. Hope you enjoyed, and we'll see you next week. I will not be able to do any casts on Saturday. However, if we do have any Friday casts, we will be back as a duo cast. Otherwise, it will be Razurial in solo casting for the semifinals of the Ryze Up Tournament 2012, hosted by LOLReport.com. Thank you for watching, and have a good night.